This is a place called Beard's Fork, a small former coal mining community located in a holler in southern West Virginia. It's not even on the map, but it's right about here. I spent a week here on a volunteer vacation, along with 19 others from all across the country, to help the local residents with various construction and school projects. Our base was the Southern Appalachian Labor School, which provides children's programs, education and training for young adults, and rehabilitation of housing. Why would all these people come to Beard's Fork and spend their vacation doing this? For me, I just felt like I needed to try something different. So, like Yogi Berra said, if you come to a fork in the road, take it. This is the dorm we stayed in for the week. It used to be an old church. Here's a tour of our deluxe accommodations and an introduction to some of my fellow volunteers.
I'm Skylar and I'll just be documenting.
This is where we sleep. It's where I play the piano but never even learn. And that's the beds. That's some more beds. That's some more beds. This is the girl's side.
So there's a couch right over there.
There's a bunk bed, four bunk beds. There's a little bed on the floor. And the coolest room in the house. Right here. And you can jump from up there. And that's basically it. So we're just gonna
shake you by the wrist here and we're gonna drag you upstairs.
We can do cribs like this.
So we're walking right now, there's Cooper, there's a hole in his back.
No, you can get under the steps.
It's the main showroom.
So right here, these are a lot of the adults. We're video documenting the trip, so say hi.
Hi.
There's a lady sleeping. Oh, she smiled. Say hi, everybody.
Hey.
Yo, how are you?
Hi, everybody.
Hey.
There's me behind the camera.
Let's show you the fridge.
Woo.
To the kitchen!
It's all the food.
Alright, this is our snacks. Fire extinguisher.
Food box.
Refrigerator.
Let's open it.
Alright, so we got some chicken. Chicken.
Pickles! Best thing in the house. Turkey bacon.
This is more food right here. This is where we make the delicious thing known as coffee. This is where we made eggs right here on this little stove. There's the overabundance of bread we have here. The one last room that we have in the house. There it is. Bed right there. So the bed right there. The closet.
In a minute.
Yeah, sorry, bathroom. Sorry. Any last words from anybody? Any last words right now?
Yeah, we rock. What Travis said. Ditto.
Every morning after breakfast, we'd have a meeting with our team leader, Artie, who grew up in Beard's Fork, to go over our plans for the day and to share our thoughts and experiences. Then we'd set out on a half-mile walk down the road to the Beard's Fork Elementary School, petting every dog along the way. While some volunteers rehabbed the house down in a nearby holler, others read to the small children or built a new pantry in the elementary school. I was put to work next door building a new dorm for volunteers. The project was nearing completion, but there was still plenty to do. This building was going to be a lot nicer than the place we were staying. We worked alongside some of the local youth who were getting training in construction work. Not that any of us really knew what we were doing. But our boss, Ralph, certainly did. We were doing all kinds of things that I would normally have gladly paid someone else to do for me. But it was gratifying to see the progress we made from day to day.
Get to work.
Is there sound on there?
Yeah.
Jim say hello. Jim is our strongest worker. We've had. Hasn't he been just like the strongest worker?
Jim is awesome. His mother.
When we were through with work, Artie took us around to see the sights, like the local swimming hole.
Almost heaven, West Virginia.
That's the Gauley Bridge over the New River Gorge. This is part of the state's natural beauty that they sing songs about and put on postcards.
Painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eye.
But we also saw the other side of West Virginia when we toured a coal mine.
It's dark as a dungeon.
A roof bolt. Unroof.
That was a tough way to make a living.
And the pleasures are few. Where the rain never falls and the sun never shines. Well, it's dark as a dungeon way down in the mine.
Artie also cooked dinner for us every night.
Okay, so we have some West Virginia cornbread.
That looks pretty good. What else we got?
So we have some cornbread, and we're going to have some home fries. And some, this is typical West Virginian fare. This is something we have at least once a week. I mean, I don't eat pork chops, but when I did, when I was a kid.
Except that's not your real voice.
No, it's not my real voice.
He's actually Jamaican.
I would do my Indian accent for you.
Oh, okay.
This is Kerry cornbread.
We ate dinner in the elementary school lunchroom, where there's a very strict code of conduct. On our last night in Beard's Fork, we created a poster with all our handprints on it to present to Artie. It symbolized our coming together and working as a team.
I'm just going to say that thank you for leading this awesome team. Thank you for letting us help the beautiful Beard's Fork, Virginia. Thank you for just being purely awesome. So, yeah. To you, Artie Mullet. Thank you.
So we all headed back home, knowing we did something worthwhile for the folks of Beard's Fork, as well as ourselves.